When working in Smoke, there are a few auxiliary tools that could come in handy. You will find these tools in the Tools area. To access these tools, switch to the Tools tab located at the bottom of the interface. At this point, the viewing area automatically switches to the thumbnail view. The thumbnail view is another representation of the contents in a specified folder. You can interact with the clips as well as organize them in the thumbnail view. To choose which folder to view, click on the empty box next to the folder's name. The eye icon indicates what contents are displayed in the thumbnail view. The tools are arranged in a series of clickable tabs. You have Clip Tools and Utilities. To use these tools, simply select the button. Now, before the tool's parameters are exposed, you need to select the media, if any, that the tool will be expecting to use for the specific task. This is a loading operation. Some tools will expect a front or foreground image, a back or background image, possibly to composite with, and finally a matte or alpha image to either key or isolate a region of the front input. The expected inputs column is where you set this up, as well as the behavior of the tool before entering it. So in the first pull-down menu, you choose how many inputs and what kind of inputs are being loaded. For this video, I'll choose to load 3 source clips. We have a foreground, a background, and a matte clip. I'd like to bring your attention to the cursor. Let's discuss the color of the cursor for a moment. The colors indicate the type of input the tool is expecting. Red represents the front or foreground input. This refers to the media that you're working on, perhaps doing some wire removal with paint. Click the foreground clip to select it. The cursor changes to green, which represents the background input. This could be media that you're using as a reference for a task. Once again, click anywhere on the background clip to select it. The cursor now turns blue, which represents the alpha or matte input to be loaded. Finally, click anywhere on the alpha clip to load it into the tool. We now have a white cursor. I just want to point out that the same color scheme is used in the ConnectFX node-based compositing workflow. The red is for the foreground or front input, the green is for the background, and finally the blue is the alpha or matte. This should help keep you consistent when understanding what inputs go where and what they do in specific tools. Finally, the white cursor indicates the result. You can now click anywhere in the thumbnail view and the tool will launch. It is important to note that the point where you clicked in the thumbnail view will be the expected location for the newly created source clip. Now, these tools are very versatile. You can jump in and out of the tools as you work. For example, you have been working in this tool during the current Smoke session. You jump out to do something in the sequence, and now you wish to get back into the tool with the same clips. When you select the same tool in the Tools tab, you are prompted to manually reload the source clips. However, if you enable Use Current Setup, the cursor goes white. Clicking anywhere on the thumbnail view launches you back into the tool. The source clips have been automatically loaded, and you're back to where you left off. So the tools remember their last settings even after you exit them. This is also handy if you want to apply the same operation to different clips. For example, you might have a few clips you want to interlace, burn a letterbox, or perhaps apply pulldown. But if this is not the case, get into the habit of resetting the tool after you have entered it. You do this by going to its setup menu and clicking Reset All. So the tools will always remember their settings when you are working in the current Smoke session. If you exit and restart Smoke, the settings will be reset to their default state. Finally, not every tool has an editor to perform an operation. Take Repeat, for example. Click Repeat and select a clip. To create a freeze frame or repeat a clip a number of times, set the repeat parameters. To complete this operation, just click in the thumbnail view. please move on to the next video to continue your smoke getting started experience.